Many teachers have so many PDF files that they would print out and pass along to their students during class. However, when you're online teaching, you need to have your material in the right format. So this is where that PDF to PowerPoint file conversion comes in. Plus, to really add some engagement to your class with those PDF to PowerPoint files, I'm going to show you guys how you can add a little bit of interactivity into that file. So stick around to find out how. Before we get started, I will remind everyone to just hit that subscribe button and turn on those notifications to stay updated with all of ClassPoint's latest videos. Okay, everyone, I'm Sarah and welcome to the ClassPoint channel. Today we're talking all about PDFs to PowerPoint files and making them interactive. But the first step is to do that conversion. So let's get started. If you guys are an Adobe user, you can use that account to convert your PDF file into a PowerPoint file. But if you want a free way to do this, there's so many different websites out there that you can use. The one that I'm going to be using today is just called I Love PDF. So you can search that in Google and click on that first link, and you guys will see all the different options that they have. But we want to find the one that says PDF to PowerPoint and click on that. So I have this PDF file opened up here that's just a little bit of an activity for my students to do. So this is the one when I'm going to select a PDF file from my desktop here, and I can open that up. Once it's uploaded onto the website, you guys can convert it into that PowerPoint file. Once the conversion is done, you can go to download the file. Once the file is ready to be downloaded, you guys can now open up your new PowerPoint file that used to be a PDF. So when you guys open up this file, you'll notice that anything that was on your PDF can be moved around and edited as you need. So if it didn't transfer the way that you want it, feel free to make any changes. Plus, now is the part when you can add a little bit of interactivity into that PowerPoint file. So to add this interactivity, I'm going to be using ClassPoint. ClassPoint is an interactive teaching add-in for PowerPoint that allows you to get live responses from your students during class. So I already have it downloaded and installed, and when I click on the ClassPoint tab up here, you can see there's 5 different question types. All of these question types will work good for a PDF to PowerPoint file, but today I'm just going to be using 2 of them, one of them being slide drawing. So on this first slide, I want it to be slide drawing so that students can draw the relationship between the cause and effect here. On the second slide here, I want to do a short answer example. This way, students can submit their responses for this cause and effect, and that way we can view all the different responses from the students. So not everyone is going to have the same cause and effect from this worksheet. So it'll be a really fun way to start a different discussion with my students. So now that I have the buttons on my slide, I can open up the PowerPoint, and students just need to join from this class code up at the top. And when you click on your button, the question is open up for students and they can begin submitting their responses. If you guys want to learn more about ClassPoint and its different question types, you can check out the links in the description below or head on over to www.classpoint.io. And then that way you can also download and install and begin using in your classroom today. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video on converting your PDF file into a PowerPoint file, plus adding a little bit of that interactivity using ClassPoint. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.